Hello, welcome to an integral yoga chair class. My name is Sridevi. Today's class, sitting and standing. We'll be adding some standing postures and movement. So if standing isn't available to you today, I will be giving you some options that you could do in the chair, or perhaps you'll even come up with some of your own. So to begin, make sure that the chair that you have is solid and it's not going to slide. This is a very heavy chair, so I'm pretty comfortable. If you have a light chair, maybe you'd want to put it up or a piece of furniture so it doesn't slide. So main thing, you're not going to slip. Then you want to be able to sit a little forward in the chair and have the knees over the ankles, like so, and keeping them long. Now, if the back gets tired and you'd like to scoot back in your chair, you can do that. But then, like you see with me, then my feet dangle. So it's a good idea to have a cushion or a book, something. This is a firm, and you can place your feet right there so that you have some foundation for the feet. So if you already know you need that, I invite you to get your cushion. I'm moving forward, so I'm going to move mine away. I think we're ready to start. So take a moment to feel that you're sitting well, grounded in the chair. The feet are planted firmly. The back is long. You can bring these shoulders up, roll them back. You can lengthen the neck, lengthen the spine, and then notice what happens with the chin. So often we walk around like this. Not good for the neck. So gently pull that chin back and the head is open toward the sky, right? The hands are rested on the thighs. And we'll begin with some humming. So humming is self-soothing. It evokes. So we'll do three hums. When you run out of your first hum, take another breath and begin. And just enjoy that peaceful beginning vibration. So let's take a deep breath in. And now you can remove your glasses. If you're wearing glasses, we'll continue with the eye movements. So let's check your posture once more. If your back is tired, please move against the chair. And then opening the eyes, gaze to the ceiling and the floor. Ceiling, floor, keeping the head still, the jaw. And the next time that the eyes come down, you can center them, close them, send a breath around the eyes, let them relax. And now moving horizontally, opening the eyes, gazing as far to the right as you can, across the bridge of the nose to the left, back to the right, and smoothly back and forth, toning the optic nerves, opening learning centers in the brain. So many good benefits. The next time the eyes come to the right, you can center, close, send the breath. Bring the palms together and rub them briskly. You can create heat in the palms. And once you feel that heat, gently cup them around the eyes. The fingertips are in the hairline. And feel the eyes relaxing, letting go. Gently bringing the fingertips down the forehead. You can stroke the eyelids to the corners. Maybe massage the temples, the jaw, the back of the neck, anywhere that you feel you could use some attention on the neck or the head, the throat, a little bit on the shoulders. And then you can place the hands back down. If you need, you could put them on again. And we'll continue warming up the body now with some gentle neck movements. So let's just begin by looking over one shoulder. Head around to look over the other shoulder. And just continue at your own pace, just as if you could rotate the head back and forth very easily. Maybe there's snapping and cracking, popping, that's okay. Things are moving around. Let's go one more time and then back to center and stretch out the side of the neck. So for this, hand on the chair, the other hand will come overhead and see if you can touch the opposite ear. And if your arm doesn't go that far, that's okay. Just keep it wherever it will go. And we're gently just going to press head. So we're pressing one ear toward the shoulder. You can press down on the other hand and just not, don't want to intensify it too much, but you can really feel a release in the neck. And then coming back to center. And we'll do the other side. Maybe a little roll there. Other hand over. And pressing down on the chair, gently release. As I said, if your arm doesn't come up all this way, it could come here, it could even stay down. But we're just gently releasing the side of the neck and then coming back to center. Let's just do some front this way and that way. And now bringing the fingertips to the tops of the shoulders, elbows pointed out to the side. If the arms don't come up that far, here, wherever they happen to go. So for this, we're going to pay attention to the shoulder blades, bringing the elbows towards each other. Feel the shoulder blades separate. And then as you open, you can together. So once more, bring the elbows together, open. So just imagine that you're trying to have the elbows meet behind you. I doubt if they will. Maybe you're super flexible. I don't know. Open and lift the heart. Let's do this a few more times. So if you're not able to reach the shoulders, it might look like this on you if you're placing your hands on the chest. And that would be okay too. And maybe once more, and release. Let the arms shake. And then once more, back on top or here. And this time we'll lift the elbows up. See, bring the wrists towards each other behind you, and then releasing the elbows come down. Inhaling, bring them up. And again, we don't care how far they go. Maybe you're here. It's okay. Go to where it feels best for you. You're moving, you're breathing. Hopefully you're having fun, right? That's what counts. One more time, lifting up, down, and release. Now let's take a look at the fingers. So extend the fingers, open them wide. We'll make some webs. Then we're going to bend the knuckles for, put the thumb underneath. We have some beaks here, beaks. And then wrap the fingers for paws. All right, so we go webs, claws, beaks, and paws. Again, webs, claws, beaks, and paws. Now, keeping one paw, you're going to support the elbow and just rotate that wrist one way, the opposite way. And then, of course, we have to have the Queen's wave, right? Just rotating the arm And then release. And the other side now, making our paw fist, supporting the. And circling one direction and the opposite direction. Wave to your subjects. We can be haughty. We can be haughty about it. And then we can release. And now I think it's time to rotate the shoulders by getting in our boat. So take your hands, grab your oar. We go with that very well-known yogic song. This is what it's all about. And row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Okay, so they say, let's move a little bit forward. We're going to extend the leg. So bring one leg out and just gently move the knee back and forth. And then you can extend the heel. So we're going to do some flexing. Flexing, you can lift the leg. This can help build strength in the thigh if you lift the leg. But if that's not available, place the heel down and just keep the point and the flex. And a few times, now we can rotate. Again, you could lift the leg to do this, or you could keep the heel grounded. Rotating a few times, one direction and the opposite direction. And just give it a little wiggle and a shake. Plant it well and extend the opposite leg. So again, as you rotate, we can be up in the air or grounded. No, I'm sorry, we have to flex and point first. Well, I guess it doesn't matter as long as we're moving. So let's do the flex and the point. Up and down. Oh, I'm having some creaking. That's so great. And there we go. All right. So now it's time to stand up and move. And the way we're going to do this is we'll just can stand up without using your hands. Okay, don't start yet because we're going to do this a few times. If you need to use the seat, feel free to do that. For those of you who aren't able to stand, you could lift one, or you could count with us. You could be our counters. I'm just going to put that aside. Okay, so here we go. We're going to stand up and down 8 times. And up and down, 2 and 3, 4, 5. See if you can keep the back lifted. And we have 7 and 1 more. Up. Hooray. So moving now to the side of your chair. And those that are still sitting, I'll give you an option in a moment. So we'll be doing some standing poses that are good for strength and balance. Especially as we get older, we know how important that is. So we'll start with the tree pose. So coming to the side of your chair. Now you can put your hip, or you can stand away and use your arm. I'll leave that up to you. Round the feet really well. Make sure the knees aren't locked. So the leg closest to the chair, you're going to ground that foot, pull up on the hip, turn the other leg out. And you could start just the foot and the heel at the ankle. And this might be enough for you. Maybe you want to bring that palms in namaste. If you'd like to go a little further, bring the foot up to the calf. Or you could bring it, if you're very flexible, all the way into the thigh. But the main thing is you don't want to place it against the knee. Knees are very fragile. So below the knee or above the knee. And once you find your spot, you can look for something to stare at, to focus on. And then see how comfortable you are with trying to balance. So those in the chair, what you can do is extend this leg out, turn the other one out. Now you may not be able to straighten this. Maybe you can. Maybe you could go with a straight leg. But if not, you're here, right? Pressing down. Make sure that knee's over. And you can still get some strength in that leg just pressing down on it. Okay, so let's shake that out. Go to the other side. So once again, probably be different. Inner leg grounds. Turning out the outer leg. Place the heel in the ankle or the calf or all the way to the thigh. It's up. Once you find your spot, you can hold onto the chair or maybe have your hip against the chair for some stability. And then maybe put the hands in namaste. On this side, we could grow branches. It's a little windy today. We could blow in the wind. And then coming down, release, and we'll shake that leg out. So the next part, I'm going to turn my chair, so hopefully you can see. And this is called the Sonja Heine. So some of you, if you're old enough probably to know who that is, this was named by my 90 yoginis in Bluffton, Indiana at River Terrace. So she was an ice skater, movie star ice skater. So what we're going to do is extend one leg behind, extend the opposite leg. Or arm, sorry. And then you could stay here, or you could lift that back leg and maybe even come forward, gliding across the ice. And then coming back up and release. So going to the other side, extend the back leg. Lifting the arm. Free to stay here with that toe grounded or take off across the ice and keep them up, Emma. Keep them up. Ooh, looking up, lengthening, reaching. And back up and down. And now we're going to go from ice skating to being warriors, peaceful warriors. Let's good. So warrior two. So for this, the leg that you're going to bend, put it right behind the chair. Maybe it can turn out a little bit. Your other leg comes behind, facing this, holding onto the chair. This hand can be on the hip, or you could extend it out if you're balanced. Bending that knee and using this arm for support. You could also place that chair and maybe lift this arm. And then gazing over the fingers that are on the chair. Keeping the heart open and lifted. Well into the feet. And then straighten and bring the feet together and we'll walk to the other side. So I may need to adjust here. Again, the bent leg goes behind the chair leg, other leg behind. Bend the knee. And there. And I forgot people sitting. So those of you standing, stay there. If you're sitting, you can extend one leg behind, bend this leg, and just however far this leg will go, maybe the way, that's okay. You may look like this. That's fine, you may look like that. You may look like this. Great. Great warriors. Okay, well now you can come out. We're going to now do one more movement to a song, Daisy, Daisy. And the movement is going to go like this. So hold there. We're going to kick to the front. Kick to the front and then to the side. Then the next movement, the knee comes up. We're going to go in and out. Then up, out, down. So I'll be doing this with you. You can follow me, but just so you have a general idea. Those in the chair, do it right from here, right? Terrific. Here we go. And please, if you know this, sing along with me. Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer true. I'm half crazy, love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage. I can't afford a carriage, but you'll look sweet up on the seat of a bicycle built for two. Very good. Now, what does Daisy say? Daisy says, her reply is, Henry, Henry, here is your answer true. You're half crazy if you think I'll marry you. You can't afford a carriage. There won't be any marriage. For I'll be hitched on a bicycle built for two. Terrific! Yay! Let's come and sit down. Ah, I'm a little out of breath. Maybe you are too. And we're going to laugh on our bike and then relax. So get on your bike. Here we go. You can use your arms. Make sure you're not going to fall off. Hold on if you need to. We're going to laugh. Make yourself laugh. Here we go. Ah! A pillow if your feet don't touch the floor. Place it there. That's what I'm going to do to sit back. Something else I want to show you. So for the neck, if you have a throw or a little blanket, or even when we used to fly, right, those inflatable things around the neck, for more comfort, you could put this behind your neck. Like so, you can hold it or relax the hands. So let's take a moment to settle down and get comfortable. Anything, make any adjustment that you might need to make. And then get comfy. So to relax the body a little further, we'll be doing a guided relaxation. So if you find any tension that's in the body that we missed, see if you can use the breath and the mind. So with the eyes closed or soft eyes, bring your awareness to the toes. Feel that the toes, the feet, and the ankles are relaxed. The hips, the legs relax, the buttocks relaxed. The fingers, hands, and wrists are relaxed. The forearms, the elbows, and upper arms. The shoulders relaxed. The belly, the chest, relaxed, the entire back sinking into the chair. Feel the neck is relaxed. the jaw, the tongue, lips, teeth, cheeks, and eyes all relaxed. So just feel that every physical part of the atom, every cell, is completely relaxed. And just take a moment to observe that relaxed body. And now bring your awareness to your breath. And just observe how easy and gentle the breath is. It might be you're not breathing. Just gently observe and watch the breath. Notice the thoughts going through the mind. And just imagine these thoughts as if they were clouds drifting through the sky. Nothing to do with you, just coming and going. Let them come and go. And as you watch the thoughts, you can observe the mind. Notice the sense of peace. And know that you are this peace. That is your true nature. And so allow yourself a few minutes now. Everything else. And just be that peace. That peace that was meant to be. It's you. Om Shanti. Bring your awareness back to your breath. Deepen the inhalations and fill the body with renewed energy and vitality. And as you exhale, release any tension. Just start to wiggle the fingers and the toes gently. Maybe having a little stretch. And if you can, then come a little onto the chair. And we'll just do a little bit of a breathing practice. So today we'll do Nadi Sudhi, the alternate nostril breath. So this is a very calming breath. It activates the parasympathetic nervous system. So we use a mudra with this. You make a gentle fist with the right hand, extend the thumb, the pinky, and the ring finger. Turn it toward the face. Close the right nostril with the thumb as you exhale through the left. Inhale through the left. Close with the last two fingers. Exhale through the right. Inhale right. Back and forth. So if this mudra you find difficult, you could just take your fingers back and forth like so. Do what's comfortable for you. So exhaling through the right. And close and exhale through the left. So you could close your eyes. And just see if you can try some smooth, gentle, easy breaths in and out. If this doesn't to you, then you could drop the hand and just do some deep three-part breathing. But I know some of you out there do like Nadi Sudi, so feel free to do that. We'll just do that for maybe a few seconds or so. Without rushing, time that you exhale through the right nostril, you can release the hand. And we'll just have a very brief moment of meditation. So we'll just do a hum together, like we did in the and then keeping the eyes closed or soft eyes, we'll start to train the mind to be one-pointed. So give the mind an activity. You could give it a word to come back to, a piece of scripture, a positive and beautiful. If you're using scripture, I do a very short phrase. I am is one I like to use. I am. Anything you like. So peace is good. Let's hum together and then see if we can keep the mind as it will start to wander off and gently, like you would a little child, just guide it right back to where you want it to go. All right? So take a moment, think of what you're going to guide. Close the eyes. Let's do a hum together. You can open your eyes. Thank you so much for joining today. It's been my pleasure, and I hope to see you again. Namaste.